Good morning. I am David, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Rohini College of Engineering and Technology. In this video, I am going to explain the electro-pneumatic circuit from the 4th unit of Hydraulics and Pneumatics subject. Note syllabus, the 4th unit title is Pneumatic and Electro-Pneumatic Systems. So let us consider a problem, that is design of pneumatic circuit for the sequence of operations A plus, B plus, B minus, A minus by cascade method. First you have to understand what is this sequence of operations. In this sequence of operation, there are two cylinders are available, that is A and B. A plus means the plus indicates extension of cylinder, minus indicates the retraction of cylinder. So the sequence of operation is A cylinder extends, B cylinder extends, B cylinder retracts, A cylinder retracts. So in for making this circuit, we need two cylinders. So we have to decide the components first. The number of cylinders required is two, named as A and B. The number of groups is two. There can be decided by some methods, that is in every group the number of operations available should not exceed the number of cylinders, and also we should not change the sequence of operation, and also in the same group same cylinder operation should not repeat. By means of these conditions, we can say, we can divide the groups as A plus, B plus and B minus, A minus. So number of groups is 2, number of pressure lines is equal to number of groups, that is equal to 2, number of cascade valve is equal to number of groups minus 1, so 2 minus 1 is equal to 1, number of DCV, direction control valve, is equal to number of cylinders, so 2. Number of limit switches is 2 for each cylinders, so 2 into 2, that is equal to 4. Now we can fix the components in the circuit. 2 cylinders, 2 DCV, 4 limit switches, 2 pressure lines, 1 cascade valve. Now we have to make the connection to make this sequence. First we have to give connection to the pressure lines. Okay, pressure lines, and also we have to think one thing. The pressure line 1 will do the first group operations and pressure line 2 will do the second group operations. So this is cascade valve. This cascade valve energizes the pressure lines. So first we have to give the connection for cascade valve. So the direct connection from the compressor must be given to the pressure line 1. Then return connection must be from the pressure line 2 given to the return connection, that is atmosphere. It went to the atmosphere. Then give connection to the hydraulic cylinders or pneumatic cylinders, I think. So as usual, in a double acting cylinder, give connection from the compressor to the blank end of the cylinder. Then return connection must be given to the vent. Here also. So this is the limit switch for retraction, this is the limit switch for extension, and also like this. This is the cylinder A, this is cylinder B. Next we have to make some direct connection from the pressure line. So pressure line 1 gives the operations of A plus, B plus. So you give direct connection from the pressure line 1 to the limit switch of A plus and B plus. This is the limit switch for A. A plus means this is the limit switch. So you have to give direct connection from the pressure line 1, A plus and B plus. And also the first operation available in the group must be given directly from the pressure line. The first operation is A plus. So the DCV of A must be directly energized by pressure line 1. Okay. So now the first group direct connections are made. Then we have to make the sequence of operations. First, A plus, this connection was given. So A cylinder extends. So after extension of A cylinder, this rod will touch with this limit switch. Then we have to make B plus. B cylinder must be extends. So from this B cylinder limit switch, we have to give the direct connection to the DCV of B plus, positive side of B. Then B cylinder will be extends. Then we have to make the pressure line 2 must be energized. So from the B cylinder limit switch, B positive limit switch, we have to give the connection to the second position of cascade valve. Okay. Now the position will be changed and the pressure line 2 gets energized. Then same as first group, second group operations also must be given as direct connections. That is B minus, this is the B minus limit switch. So direct connection from the pressure line 2. Then A minus, this is A minus, direct connection from the pressure line 2. And also the first operation from the group B, group 2, that is B minus. So it will be given like this. So B cylinder retracts. At the end of retraction, this connection must be given to the A cylinder . So now A cylinder also retracts. Now we have to change the position of cascade valve. So from A cylinder limit switch, from minus position, we have to give the connection to the first position of cascade valve. So again the sequence of operation will be repeated. So almost you may study about the connections of pneumatic circuit by cascade method. So we can see the fifth unit video next time. Thank you.